Lisbon sidewalks are not made for Americans, for sure. Even some Indians will struggle, you know, with their bellies getting stuck between this gap. Much better now. Actually already in the center of Lisbon, and I'm heading towards these guys called Sportclasse. It looks like I am almost there. Should be somewhere over there. Oh man, look at all the Porsches. By the way, I forgot to mention, these guys are Porsche specialists. I'm gonna go in and check it out now.
This car is a 911S. It's this car here. If you can see.
1972, okay.
It belonged to Americ Nunes.
And these are all the rallies.
All the rallies that he did.
Wow.
And like the ones he won. This livery and the details you see on the car, it's from a rally that Americ Nunes won. Which is what. The Soul, like it says here.
The Soul, yes.
And it was first place in 1978. This car belonged to my granddad.
Ah, okay.
So my dad owns the business now. He's the owner of the car. And it's like a family.
It's a family business.
Yes. All these cars that you see here belong to Americ. This car is the 906 that will be in the show tomorrow.
Okay.
This one, it still races into the European Classic Championship. It's one of the cars that won a lot of prizes. Americ was five times national champion.
And he raced not just in Portugal, is it? He raced other places as well?
Yes, he tried Rally Monte Carlo, for example.
Ah, he did the Monte Carlo as well?
Yes.
Wow, that's awesome.
That car was made by Porsche itself. And they are just two that exist at the moment. One is at the museum and the other one as a private owner. And we don't know which one belonged to him, if it's the one at the museum or the other one.
You'll probably have to check the chassis numbers.
Yes.
And then can find out. I am going there maybe next month. Okay. If you want, I'll peek inside. I'll find the chassis number and let you know.
Okay.
Those are the 924s, yes?
Yes, Carrera GT. We have five of them. Four grey ones and one red.
How much do these cars, how much is the expected price for the Carrera GT now? The approximate, like?
Like 90,000, 100,000.
Also, still less than the 911.
Yes, of course.
Because the transaxle cars are now gaining value. Earlier, the transaxle cars didn't have that much value comparatively. There are cars stacked one on top of the other, and you just, you know, you like how you have those vending machines where you press a button. No, I want this. It's like this. It's like a vending machine for kick-ass classic cars, Porsches, classic Porsches rather.
Exactly.
Wow, it's been an awesome pleasure talking to this guy, because clearly he knows his Porsches, if you can just see around. And of course, he knows how to race Porsches as well, because he's the third person in the generation who's been doing that. And I am going to try going with him tomorrow to Estoril, where I think there are 300 cars.
Yes.
Where there are 300 cars, 300 Porsches, which are coming down from, I think, all over Portugal to celebrate the 70th year anniversary of Porsche. I hope it's going to be good fun. I think, I'm sure it's going to be good
fun. It will.
It will be. Ciao. Also, if you're done looking at cars, if you're done looking at Porsches, here's a very, very cool 917 livery pinball table. Doesn't get better than that. You might even use the GoPro also if you want.
Checkpoint!
Oh shit! Lisbon, and I'm here for the Porsche Iberia 70th anniversary celebrations, where they have Porsche cars which have come from all across Spain, all across Portugal, to celebrate the 70 years of Porsche. These two cars over here are from the same owner. This is a 911 ST replica. And this here is a 911 R replica. They're replicas, but still very cool. The classic 911 R twin tail lights. Really cool.
Now sit there.
Okay.
And put your legs to
like
the
this.
Side. Yeah, yeah. This is a celebration one.
Yeah.
Like slowly. Are
we going on the back?
Yes.
Oh, super.
It's better than staying outside.
Of course. This is my first time on the Estrel track and I've got the best seat in the house. Andre's driving us on the track.